One of the key pillars to BASF Global Company Strategy is to keep the needs of our customers central to our focus. Within the BASF South African Agricultural Solutions business, this is no different. We are committed to farming. Many of our customers have found that Conyza or scroll-hans control under no-till farming practices has become more challenging year on year. We decided to investigate and find solutions. Within no-till farming practices, a key tool for weed control has been removed, the plow, a highly effective method for weed control, leaving the farmer with fewer solutions to control weeds. No-till farmers rely on herbicides, and when used correctly, is highly effective. However, herbicides have their limitations, especially when it comes to weeds classified as difficult to control, such as Conyza. As a general rule, herbicide recommendations are that better control can be expected when weeds are newly germinated. The bigger weeds grow, the more difficult they are to control. To compound the problem, we see many farmers using the same herbicides year in and year out. This, however, can lead to a buildup of herbicide tolerant or even resistant populations. Our investigation resulted in the following findings that we'd like to share with you. We start off with the typical season rotations: spring, summer, autumn, and winter. Usually planting will start during spring, depending on the rain and soil temperatures. Following the normal crop growth cycle, harvesting will take place anytime during autumn and into winter. The majority of South African farmers who keep sheep or cattle will send these animals into the fields to graze on the crop residues and other plants present, such as weeds. Let's look at the weed control program. In the usual no-till farming practice, before planting begins, a pre-plant burn-down herbicide application is made to clean the fields from any weeds present. This is to ensure crops are planted on a clean and weed-free field. When the conditions are optimal, planting of the crop will begin. Typically, at plant or directly after planting, the farmer will apply the first pre-emergent herbicide. This pre-emergent herbicide creates a barrier in the soil surface so that any weeds that germinate will make contact with the herbicide while germinating and thus should be controlled. It is important to protect the crop from weed competition during the early stages of crop development to achieve higher yields. This pre-emergent herbicide creates a barrier in the soil so that any weeds that germinate will make contact with the herbicide while germinating and thus should be controlled. It is important to protect the crop from weed competition during early stages of crop development to achieve higher yields. This pre-emergent herbicide will over time decrease in efficacy, resulting in less effective weed control. When the pre-emergent herbicide has no residual activity left, the farmer will apply a post-emergent herbicide containing a soil residual component. The objective is to control already emerged weeds and to control weeds that are not emerged yet. This application will offer weed control usually until the crop has formed a canopy. Weeds generally do not grow well in the shade of the crop. After the application of this post-emergent herbicide, no further weed control measures are made until the next season starts with the pre-plant burndown, and so the process continues. Now we will overlay the normal growth patterns of Conyza in this cycle of no-till farming. To start off, a few facts about Conyza. Each Conyza plant can produce up to 240,000 seeds per plant. These seeds are wind dispersed and can spread for hundreds of kilometers. Conyza has an effective natural defense mechanism, namely very fine hairs on the leaves and stem that hold dust. This combination limits and neutralizes herbicides from entering the plant tissue. Conyza also has a natural tolerance to herbicides, and the bigger it grows, the higher its tolerance becomes. Conyza seeds prefer conditions where there is no soil movement and will only germinate in the very top layer of the soil when exposed to light. Ideal conditions under no-till practices. Let's look at the growth cycle of Conyza under these no-till situations. When the crop canopy starts to die off, sunlight penetrates the spaces between the rows and stimulates the Conyza to germinate. At this point, the last herbicide application has little to no effect on the germinating Conyza. Once the crop is ready for harvest, it will be removed from the field, and soon after the cattle will be sent in to graze. The cattle will graze on all the material available, including the above parts of the Conyza, leaving the root system intact from where it will regrow. During winter, the Conyza, regardless of grazing, will form a rosette. The weed will appear to be growing very slowly, however, the taproot of the weed will grow extensively below the soil, building energy reserves for later growth stages. The Conyza will remain in this rosette phase for the duration of winter. While in this rosette phase, the above ground parts of the weed will be exposed to frost and other climatic conditions. This causes the leaves of the Conyza to become tough, commonly termed as winter hardened. The Conyza weed now has a large taproot with lots of energy reserves and hairy, tough leaves. Early in spring, when temperatures start to rise and the day length increases, the Conyza will start to bolt. At this stage of the weed growth cycle, it is often assumed that the weed is still young. However, at this stage, the weed is already several months old. At this point, the farmers start their pre-plant burn down applications with the usual herbicide products such as glyphosate and 2,4-D. Reports have shown that application rates have to be increased year on year to achieve the same results, or the results are simply not ideal. During spring and after bolting phase, the Conyza will begin its seed production phase. The seeds will be wind dispersed and further infect surrounding fields. This is the normal growth cycle of Conyza in a summer rainfall area, but it is crucial to note that this process can happen throughout the year as long as conditions are optimal. Given all this information under a typical no-till situation, a few things need to be considered. The use of mechanical weed control methods such as plowing is not a viable option. Herbicides do have their limitations, such as penetrating the stubble layer on top of the soil to make contact with these newly germinating weeds. Biology of the weed and growth timing, and increased tolerance to certain herbicides. So when is the best time to control Conyza in your field? The BASF team has conducted several trials under different conditions to establish the best methods to control Conyza in no-till fields. Together with our partner farmers, we have concluded that the most effective management program is as follows. Given the facts, it is clear that an effective weed control strategy will not only save you on your labor and your costs, but you will enjoy higher yields as well.